Hello everyone, welcome back to 31 Days of Wisdom, and today we are doing chapter 12. I'll just get into it. Whoever loves discipline loves knowledge, but whoever hates correction is stupid. Good people obtain favor from the Lord, but he condemns those who devise wicked schemes. No one can be established through wickedness, but the righteous cannot be uprooted. A wife of noble character is her husband's crown, but a disgraceful wife is like a decay in his bones. The plans of the righteous are just. But the advice of the wicked is deceitful. The words of the wicked lie in wait for blood, but the speech of the upright rescues them. The wicked are overthrown and are no more, but the house of the righteous stands firm. A person is praised according to their prudence, and one with warped mind is despised. Warped. Better to be a nobody and yet have a servant than to pretend to be somebody and have no food. The righteous care for the needs of their animals, but the kindest acts of the wicked are cruel. Those who work their land will have an abundant food, but those who chase fantasies have no sense. The wicked desire the stronghold of evildoers, but the root of the righteous endures. Evildoers are trapped by their sinful talk, and so the innocent escape trouble. From the fruit of their lips, people are filled with good things, and the work of their hands bring them reward. The way of fools seems right to them, but the wise listen to advice. Fools show their annoyance at once, but the prudent overlook an insult. An honest witness tells the truth, but a false witness tells lies. The words of the reckless pierce like swords, but the tongue of the wise bring healing. Truthful lips endure forever, but a lying tongue lasts only a moment. So far, I am getting that. Stop lying. Just don't lie. Just speak the truth and be open to advice and correction and instruction and discipline. I'll just keep going. Number 20. Deceit is in the heart of those who plot evil, but those who promote peace have joy. No harm overtakes the righteous, but the wicked have their fill of trouble. The Lord detests lying lips, but the Lord detests lying lips, but he delights in people who are trustworthy. The prudent keep their knowledge to themselves, but a fool's heart blurts out folly. Diligent hands will rule, but laziness ends in forced labor. Anxiety weighs down the heart, but a kind word cheers it up. The righteous choose their friends carefully, but the way of the wicked leads them astray. Wow. The lazy do not roast. The lazy are uncertain. Do not roast any gain, but the diligent feed on the riches of the hunt. In the way of the righteousness there is life. Along the path is more immortality. Okay, so some things that stood out is he who loves discipline loves knowledge, but whoever hates correction is stupid. Good people obtain favor from God. What is it to be a good person? To not lie, to speak the truth, to not be evil to other people. A wife of a noble character is her husband's crown, but a disgraceful wife is like a decay in his bones. Discipline or correction is stupid. And that's coming from the Bible. So just say, so he who loves discipline has knowledge. And the other thing, our instruction is to be a noble wife. Be a wife with a noble character. Is God preparing me to be a wife? I don't want to speak the truth. And do not speak lies. And to be open to advice. So receiving advice or correction. And also to understand it. Okay, those are some of the instructions that I saw. And diligent hands will rule, but laziness ends in forced labor. That's one of the promises. So, hardworking hands will rule. And laziness end up in forced labor. What's the other promise? Those who promote peace have joy. So promoting peace brings you joy. Not always drama. Don't promote drama. And the Lord delights in people who are trustworthy. That's another promise. Is there anything else? So, warped is unpleasant. So, just read that verse again. Number 8. A person is praised according to their prudence, and one with a unpleasant mind is despised. Okay. Under meaning, I'm also going to add what this chapter. Oh my gosh, my camera stopped recording. I'm not sure it did stop, but I was saying under meaning, I'm also going to add what does this chapter mean to me. But basically it means it's trying to tell me to speak the truth, no matter how painful it is. And with this, you will grow to be a wise person. So I'll just go. Okay, a life lesson here is... I actually really like 26. I'm going to put 26. It says, the righteous choose their friends carefully, but the way of the wicked leads them astray. So to choose your friends wisely. I was telling my sisters this. My sisters are younger than me, but they're at that age where they're making decisions for themselves now. My sister is turning 20 in 2020, and the other one is 17. And I was telling them that you rather have one genuine friend, like all you need is that one friend who will be there for you, who will protect you, who will have your back whether you are around or not around. You just need that one friend than a whole crowd of friends that are all fake to you. So yeah, I think that goes hand in hand with that choose your friends wisely. You rather even have that one friend that it will be a wise friend and will bring something that will help you grow in life, that you water each other as friends, not just one friend who's always take, and you losing and not gaining anything from them. Not even trust, you know, not even loyalty, not even wisdom. Choose your friends. Is to not be stuck in my ways. Don't be stuck in your ways. Read the Bible, get correction, get wisdom. Okay, don't think you know it all. From the wise. So if my mom is trying to correct me, I must accept it and not argue with her. So yes, that is it for chapter 12, and I will see you guys on the next video, which is tomorrow. I hope you're enjoying this 31 days of wisdom so far, like how I am enjoying it. And I love you so much, guys, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye.